Every acre of land impacts our waterways. What happens on the land and how we manage our land determines whether or not we're going to have healthy water downstream. Today, the issues that we have with our local waters come from phosphorus and sediment. Phosphorus is found in all living things. It's found in leaves, it's found in grass clippings, it is found in manure, which is our fertilizer for our farm fields. And when rain hits our land, it brings all of that into our waterways. Phosphorus just happens to be the nutrient that causes algae growth too. While it's great on the land, it helps everything grow. When it gets into our waters, it helps that algae grow. The other thing is sediment, and it's just dirt. It's dirt from construction fields, it's dirt from farm fields. Anytime that dirt gets in our waterways, that's pollution in our waters, and it's causing things like fish kills. If we can get more water to stay on site and soak in on site, less pollution will enter our waterways. And that's what this project is all about.
Agricultural runoff treatment systems, ARTS, can be placed creatively depending on where surface water impacts the field area. In this example, surface runoff from the land that drains to the area of interest in the field will be captured in an initial basin where sediment can settle out. Runoff water will then move through a series of additional vegetated basins to settle out even more sediment. In these basins, nutrients like phosphorus and nitrogen can be absorbed by the growing plants. Before the water goes back to the local stream, it can also pass through additional treatment to further remove excess nutrients from the water. Here, the final deep basin could also be a water reuse source for close crop fields. A system like this can also capture and slow down surface water runoff from severe storm events, offering both time and treatment of this water before entering the local stream.
My favorite definition would be we have our conservation goals for the watershed, and we know our landowners have goals for their property. And so the treatment system is meant to align both of those goals. We have areas where our stream banks are eroding very severely. We have flooding happening. And so the goal of the ARTS is to restore hydrology. And by restoring hydrology, we at least slow down or limit the amount of erosion happening downstream. ARTS are installed in the existing system of where runoff occurs off the landscape. Like behind me here, for example, is a system where the river is very flashy and we take advantage of that. We harvest that water, we treat it, and we put it back in the same river. Basically, we're finding spots on the landscape that are either the fields are too small for the farmer to farm, or it's the most efficient way to collect water.
I was having a Ford crossing put in right over here on the creek, and I asked, would you guys permit a pond for me if I wanted to dig a pond out here? And he said, well, you know, there are a lot of things going on that maybe there's a way to get a pond where you don't have to participate fully in the cost. And he went on to talk about these runoff ponds. Good for the environment. You know, it's good for wildlife. It improved the wildlife habitat. It accomplished a bunch of good things, and it was easy for me to participate.
Things that we can do to reduce the amount of stream bank erosion, trying to reduce the capacity of water that's coming all at once is a great way to do that. So putting in wetlands and installing practices that slow the water from getting from the farm fields into the streams. Runoff treatment systems, once they fill up, we can go back in and scrape out all the material, give it back to the farmers that, you know, it came off their land in the first place. We can go put it back and it has a lot of nutrients in it. They also are slowing that water down, so that way the water isn't getting off the landscape as quickly as it could be. So if we can store the water up further in the watershed and release it slowly over time, we should see a lot of benefits towards flooding, towards stream bank erosion, towards habitat, everything.
The district's involvement is primarily as a partner with both Outagamie County and Fox Wolf Watershed Alliance. The district provided the location for this sedimentation basin to be built. It was an opportunity for us to have an impact on the environment outside the fence, so to speak, of the treatment plant itself. The ART systems for us is a low-tech yet effective mechanism to improve water quality that certainly will benefit everybody in the long run.
the long-term benefits is going to be crazy. Right now, between what these arts have been doing that Fox Wolf and Outagamie Conservation have put in Brown County Conservation, they've dramatically increased the quality of water that we've seen just in the village of Wrightstown, and I know even in some of the other bodies of water. And I think the more we get put in, the better it's going to be for all of us. The water quality is just going to keep improving.
As the old saying goes, everybody lives downstream from somebody else. In these rural upland areas, this is where our food is grown. We need agriculture to provide our society with a food source. If you have 10 1 million gallon arch systems on the edge of 10 fields, that's 10 million gallons that didn't make it downstream or doesn't go downstream as quickly. So it really minimizes the impacts of flooding and eases the burden on the downstream infrastructure that need to handle that big slug of water that happens after these big runoff events.
I think some landowners are starting to realize that a lot of the problems that are downstream can be fixed in the upstream areas. To incentivize, there's cost share programs affiliated with all of our projects as well that help to take off that financial burden.
There are many different reasons why a farmer or a private landowner would install an ARTS system. But those that choose to put ARTS on their land, I have to think do it because they also see that they're part of a bigger community, that they're not only doing it for the benefit that they see on their property, but also because they're benefiting what's happening downstream. These aren't really technical ideas. They are simple solutions for a complex problem. We all make a difference to what happens to our water quality, and that's what a watershed is about. It's about community, and it's about community working together to protect the resources that are most important to us.